Greetings from Florida. Here we're working on a Dodge 1500 truck, 2002 to 2010. This is the passenger side. These are different than the 1500 van. Please keep that in mind. Not the most challenging job. I'm going to show you a couple things with this. There's a screw right there, and there's a screw in the cover that goes over the side view mirror at the top. By the way, this video is at double speed. There's one or two small screws on the bottom. And then to remove the inside handle so you can get the door panel off, 10 millimeter bolt. You don't have to take it all the way out of the handle, just loosen it enough to take the handle off. Pull that up, unplug it, lift up. This panel lifts up, doesn't lift out, lifts up. Straight up, there you go. We're gonna do two things here. We're gonna replace the regulator. It was, the motor was the problem, but he also ended up with the glass clips coming off the glass. So we're gonna glue those back on as well. And normally I would probably just do that, but I think for your benefit, I think I took off the speaker. Let's see. I did. Just for you. I might not have done that if I was doing this myself. If you find this video helpful, do me a favor. Like, L-I-K-E, like the video. That will help other people, such as yourself, find it on YouTube. Just tucking that all out of the way. Putting the switch on just so I can lower. I want to make sure it's the motor first. I think I might have just banged it with a hammer. I can't remember. Nothing. Got nothing out of it. Little WD-40 on the two channels on the sides, the up and down channels on the sides. Never hurts. Just a little bit. Oh, I'd seen. Okay, the glass clips had already come off. So I put the glass up and I'm going to take out the whole regulator with the glass clips and the motor. So you've got six 10 millimeter bolts that are coming off. Yeah, his regulator was actually okay. It's solid steel, but sometimes the regulator bends. In his case, the motor went. But it's coming as an assembly. You're getting the motor and the regulator together. Yes, you can buy them separately, but it's almost the same price now to buy the whole thing together. And when I do, you'll see the glass clips there and there, 10 millimeter. Just loosen the nut a little bit. You can take off the glass clips. Try to keep the orientation the same. You want to use the same side, you know, where they go. I'm not sure why this video slows down there sometimes. Brand new iPhone, I'm not sure what the story is there. I'm going to clean off the clips just a little bit and put them on the new regulator. When I say clean them off, I'm just going to take a razor blade or a blade and just scrape off some of the glue. You don't have to get it down to the bare bones. And I believe that that's the new one. You know what? I'm just checking to make sure that the exact same ones. And where the, you can put in a bolt to line it up. There's a couple holes in the door panel, as you can see, that accept the bolts. So you can line it in and just slide it in and just put those bolts on. This might not all be visible. I apologize. This is a working farm, but I'll be showing you enough that you'll easily be able to do this. This is not a complicated job at all. If you don't feel like doing it, you'd like me to do it. If you're in Tampa Bay, Manatee County, just give me a call. Power Up Auto, I'll be glad to do it for you. If you have any questions, go ahead, ask them right here on YouTube. I'll get back to you within a day or so. And for glue, I used to use 3M structural adhesive. That was the best stuff, but they stopped making it for that application. So now I've been using a combination of, I like the JB Weld. The product's fine, and the canister, the container it comes in is good because it's got a resealable cap, an easily resealable cap, so I can use it for a couple applications. Also, on that bar, on the right-hand side that I just showed you, one of the sides of the bar is indented a bit. You'll notice the difference because on the door panel, one of the sides of the door panel comes out a little bit. And now I think I went to get some glue and something to mix it on. I'll be right back, I promise. Do 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 do. Oh, I'm back. Oh, I was missing a bolt. But I grabbed the glue too. I should have showed you, but it's a tube. It's a two-part epoxy. And it's been working out pretty well. It's pretty strong stuff. You just have to let it sit for, I don't know, about 3 or 4 minutes initially and let it cure for an hour. So now I'm bringing it down. I'm going to bring the glass down and get it in there just to make sure it lines up. Before I glue it, I'm going to make sure that it's in the proper places. Seems to be fine and dandy. And I mix the glue, and it's a clear glue, and it's thin too. It's not thick, which is a problem. I prefer when it is thick. Makes it easy to put into those clips. And then if you want to dab a little bit on the glass where it's going to go too, that's not a bad idea. Once you get it in, make sure it's all the way seated in the clips. It'll hold without a problem. I mean, you could probably just leave the clips on, but without the glue, but obviously you want the glue on there. And a little bit of WD-40 on the channels, on the side, the up and down. You don't have to soak it, just give it a light spray. And I think that's it, my friends. So I'm going to go ahead and let you watch the rest of it yourself if you'd like to. I'm sure you've seen enough to go ahead and do this. If this was beneficial, again, do me a favor, like the video. And I appreciate you watching. Have a great week.